Hi, this is John from PortableSeriaGames.com, and I'm here to show you a game on the website. So if you go to your browser, and you type in PortableFreewareGames.com, I want you to choose the Games option, and scroll down to the bottom of that page, choose page 21, and scroll down that page to get to the fourth option, the fourth game. This is it here, Stick Veterans 1.1. When you click on that wee image, and that'll take you to the download page, where you've got a video for the game, you've got a brief description of the game, and you've got a download button for the game. Let's download this. Save. And this is the file here that you'll download. StickVeterans1.1.exe. It's an .exe file, it's an executable file, and like every game on PortableFreewareGames.com, it doesn't have to be installed to run. So let's double click this. And as you can see, it opens out into this nice menu here, where you've got the name of the website, presents, the name of the game, and you've got four buttons. You've got a PISA button, you've got a README button, you've got a free VPN button, and you've got a game button. Now, starting from the top left, the PISA button is the Paid Internet Survey app, and it's basically a miniature mobile website that details the 25 best paid survey websites on the internet. Basically, websites that you sign into, you answer a questionnaire, and you get paid. Now, there's 25 of these websites listed in PISA, and out of that 25, 5 are completely free to join, so there's no financial risk, and a further 10 offer a full 60-day money-back guarantee. So if you sign up for it, and you pay your subscription fee, and you're not happy with how much money you earn after 60 days, you can just get your money back. It's a great wee thing. All you really need is an email address and some free time, and you can start earning money from the internet. And that's PISA. Underneath that is the README button. That's basically instructions for the game, and copyright owners for the game, stuff like that. Over at the right-hand side, you've got a free VPN button. This is a link to a virtual private network software that I recommend. And it's got a free version that's available. No commitment, no contract. 2 gigabytes a month, and it's good and it's fast and it's free, because running on a VPN is becoming more and more important all the time, because there's that many people out there trying to break into your privacy, whether it's hackers, government agencies, or internet service providers. They're always trying to work out what you're looking at and what websites you're visiting and what you're downloading. And a virtual private network will give you back your privacy. It's a great wee thing, it's fast and it's free, and I recommend it. And that's the free VPN button. And underneath that, last but not least, is a game button to play the game. Let's play this game. And this is a wee configuration box you get with Unity games. All you have to do is click play. And this is the game just starting up. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the music so you can hear what I'm saying. Okay, Stick Veterans. Basically, it's a fan-made tribute game to another game called Stick Soldiers, where you play as maybe stick figures with guns, with different types of guns, and you compete in missions. You can either play free-for-all, one every man for himself. You can play team games against each other, or you can play capture the flag. But we'll get to that in a minute. I'll talk you through that once we get to that option. Let's have a look at the other options you've got over here on the left. Play 3D, that's the option I recommend, that's the options I'm going to be showing you in just a minute. Play 2D, but it's not as good as the 3D version, I don't think, so I'm not going to bother showing you that. LAN matches, local area network matches. If you're playing on a local area network, you can put this game on different machines, and you can play against each other. And there's also a map editor if you want to make your own maps. That's fairly easy to do. But I don't think I'm going to do that right now. That's a tutorial for another time, another tutorial. So let's click Play 3D. And you get this configuration box up. The player name, by default, will say Player 1. So I'm going to change that to YouTube Demo. You've got an option here to use a gamepad. If you've got a gamepad, I don't. I'm just going to be using the mouse and the keyboard. So leave that blank. Map, you get all different maps to fight on. By default, it goes to this one here, Arcade Yogurt SSM. But if you want to choose a different map or explore other maps, all you have to do is click choose map. And you've got a list here of 20 or 30 different maps. Most of them have got some kind of rating on them. As you can see, there's Fibonacci, 485, Field of Play 285, Field of Play 2, 485. Like I said, most of them have got a ranking, a rating beside them, so you know if they're any good or not. But I'm just going to stick to the default map, this one here, Aki Yogurt. And then you have to choose mode, what kind of game you want. You've got free-for-all, teams, or capture the flag. I'm going to choose teams. The number of bots at any given game, 5, it's set to 5 by default, I think that's plenty. Now this is an interesting one here, bot skill. How good do you want the bots to be that you're playing against? I've got it set to easy, I've got it set to the easiest option. But even when it's easy, it's not easy, as you're going to find out in a minute or two when I start this game up. And last but not least, you've got network match, allow us to join. I'm going to click that and choose server settings, and it'll give you this configuration box. You've got to name your server. By default it'll call itself Stick Veterans, but you can call it anything you like. Password, if you leave that blank, that means people can join in without having to enter a password. Down here, auto remove ad bots when players join or leave. That's straightforward enough. If somebody joins a game, then they'll remove a bot, and if somebody leaves a game, they'll add a bot to keep the numbers the same. And underneath that, it's basically the same option again, auto balance teams if playing teams mode. Okay. And that's about ready to go, so let's make a start. One last thing I want to do is to choose a team I want to be in blue or red. I want to be a blue stick man or a red stick man. I'm going to choose blue. And here we go. And by default, you start off with just a pistol as a weapon. But you can pick up all different types of weapons as you go along. That's me dead already. You can pick up lots of different types of weapons as you go along. Kalashnikovs, rifles, shotguns, flamethrowers, and whatever else you can find. Look for a wee red guy. Oh, got one. You also top up your health as you go along. You see this. This health mixture you can see right in front of me. You take that improves your health back to you. Oh, dead. That fixes all your health problems. So as you can see, this map that we're playing on is like a framework, a cage. Carry up to three different weapons at any given time. And as you can see, it's quite a playable game. The graphics are fairly simple. Oh dear. I just fell off the side there. That's classed as suicide. The graphics are pretty simple, but it's very, very well made for being a simple game. It's very, very playable, very a lot of fun actually. Dead. play One More Life and I'll leave it at that. I don't think you need much more tutorials. One More Life after that, I don't think you need much more of a tutorial to tell you what you're doing. One thing I should really mention, is that you can toggle between third player to dead again. You can toggle between first person and third person. The third person is what it is right now. That's the one I prefer. If you want to go to first player, first person, you just right click your mouse and that's to the first player. That's it. Third person or first person, you can make your choice and play the player however you like. So we've got a bad guy there. Dead. Now I'm going to leave it at that. I don't think you really need to know any more than what I've shown you, how to play the game. And as you can see, I'm not very good at it. I've only played it a couple of times, but in time you will get better at it. So I hope you download this game. I hope you enjoy this game. I hope you have a lot of fun playing this game. And I hope you subscribe. Thanks for watching.